Hi everyone, I hope my last video helped you to learn about using Syncfusion components in a Blazor server app. So now in this video, I'm going to talk about how to configure and use the Blazor components of Syncfusion in a Blazor WebAssembly app. We saw that the Blazor server app runs at the server side in ASP.NET Core. In contrast to that, if you take a look at the Blazor WebAssembly app, it is completely designed to run at the client-side browser on a WebAssembly-based .NET runtime. So in this video, let's see how the Blazor WebAssembly app works and also how to add Syncfusion components to it. Talking about the Blazor server app, it uses SignalR connection to communicate and handle the UI and event updates between the server and client. But here in the WebAssembly apps, the Blazor app dependencies and the .NET runtime are downloaded to the browser. So the app will run directly on the browser UI, and any UI updates or event handling will all occur at the same client side. So you are automatically allowed to work offline with no necessity of having established connection all the time between the server and the client. To download all these necessary dependencies at the client side, the Blazor WebAssembly app uses a specific script file reference, which is blazor.webassembly.js. You can notice this Blazor WebAssembly file reference within the index.html file of your application. Now let's start to create the first client-side Blazor WebAssembly app. For that, I should have the .NET Core SDK 3.1 in my machine. And next, I should have either the Visual Studio Code or Visual Studio 2019 installed in my machine. So first I'll start to create a Blazor WebAssembly app using Visual Studio 2019, and at the later part I'll show you the same using Visual Studio Code. So now I'll open Visual Studio 2019 and start to create a new project by choosing Create a New Project, and then from the listed project templates I'll choose Blazor app and click Next to proceed further with the project creation. And here I'll configure it by giving a unique name, My WebAssembly App, and then click the Create button to create a new project with the default configuration. So here I have been asked to choose the Blazor project type, so I'll choose the Blazor WebAssembly App from here. In case if you are not able to find this WebAssembly App option in this project template, then you need to install it manually for your Visual Studio 2019. So let me tell you how to do that. First, open the command prompt, and here I'll need to type in the command .NET new Microsoft.ASP.NET Core .templates with a specific version. So here I have chosen the latest available version. I have already installed this Blazor template in my machine, so I should be able to create the Blazor WebAssembly app both using Visual Studio 2019 and Visual Studio Code. This is why you can see the Blazor WebAssembly app option is being displayed on the project template. So let me close it and I'll click the create button. So now my new project has been created. You can look at these project files that are available under this newly created Blazor project. Just similar to the server app, you can see a few built-in components that are available under the pages folder. All these components, namely counter, fetch data, and index, are all built with the Razor extensions. Say for example, if you take a look at this counter component, it is same as what we saw in our previous Blazor server app. And in the same way, you can write the C# code and HTML markups here in these component files. So let me run this example and show you the default output first. So here you can see the home page at the initial load with the content provided in the index component. Now let me show you in the developer tools of the browser. And here you can notice the blazor.webassembly.js file, and you can also notice other Blazor app dependencies that are downloaded at the browser end. So this is why the client-side WebAssembly applications will run directly on the browser UI, and any UI updates or event handling will all occur at the same client side. Now let me tell you how to add few of the Syncfusion components to this home page. So I'll open my application, and as a first step, I need to install the syncfusion.blazor-nuget package into my application. So for that, I'll need to open the NuGet package manager. I'll right-click my project and choose Manage NuGet Packages, And then under the browse tab, I'll search for syncfusion.blazor and I need to install this. So I'll click the install button and let me wait for a moment to get it installed. So after it is being installed, you can check it under the dependencies folder, under the packages folder. You can see the latest version of syncfusion.blazor. So now there are just three more steps remaining to add a syncfusion component to this WebAssembly app. So first I'll open the imports.razor file and here I'll need to add the syncfusion blazor component namespace. I'm planning to add a simple calendar component to this application first. So I'll add the namespace syncfusion.blazor. Now you can see a list of components available under the blazor namespace and from that I'll select calendars. By adding it here, I can start to use the syncfusion blazor calendar component in any of the components available under this pages folder. Now the second step is to register the syncfusion blazor service. For that, I'll open the program.cs file and here within this async main method, I'll need to add the syncfusion blazor service method. For that, first I'll refer the namespace syncfusion.blazor. And then within the async main method, I'll make a call to the service add syncfusion blazor. And next I need to register the valid license key of Essential Studio into my application. For that, within this same async main method, I'll register the key using syncfusion.licensing.syncfusionlicenseprovider.registerlicense. And here I need to provide a valid license key. As I already have my own trial key, so I'll use it over here. In case if you are in need of trial key, then you can check our start trials page under your syncfusion account. So the link for which I have shared in the below description part and you can make use of it. So now I'll move on to the next step where I need to refer the required CSS to render the syncfusion blazor components. So within this www root folder, I'll open the index.html page and here I need to add a reference to the CSS file first. Now everything is configured and let's see how to add the calendar component to this project. I'll open the index component under pages folder and here after this survey prompt component, I'll add calendar tag with its initial type value property set to date time and I'll close this tag and that's it. So I'll save all the changes now and run my application. And here you can see a simple calendar component getting displayed in the home page. So just like how I added a simple calendar component, I can also add some other syncfusion component, say a grid component. For that, I just need to do two things additionally. So first, inside the imports.razor file, I'll need to import the syncfusion.blazor. From a list of components, I need to select grids. And then within the index component, I'll add the grid tag. Now I need to provide some input data source to this grid component so that it can display them in a tabular format. So let me add the code section. And within this code section, I'll use my existing model class with the name employee over here, which has some valid fields like employee ID, name, designation, date of joining, and salary. And also I'll define a list variable employee data and generate an array of employee data to store in this particular list variable. So for that, I'll override the onInitialized method. I'm generating the list of employee data by providing some valid values to each of the fields. And now I'll assign this employee data variable to the grid's data source property using at directive. And now I'll save the changes and run my application again. And here you can see a grid component displaying a list of employee data along with the calendar component displayed at the top in the same home page. In this way, you can add any of the syncfusion components to the Blazor WebAssembly app and also configure them with its different available features. Now let's see how to create the same WebAssembly app using Visual Studio Code. So I have opened the Visual Studio Code now. And before proceeding further, make sure that you have installed ASP.NET Core Blazor templates in your machine, which I have showed you while explaining with Visual Studio 2019. So I'll skip this step here. In case if you have not installed it before, make sure to do it first before proceeding to create the WebAssembly app. So now I'll open the integrated terminal and start to create a new Blazor WebAssembly project by typing in the command .NET new Blazor version hyphen o, and I'll provide a name for my Blazor project as my Blazor app and hit the enter button. So this will create a new Blazor project template with the necessary project files. Next, I need to install the Syncfusion Blazor packages into my project. I'll navigate to my newly created project folder, which is my Blazor app, using the cd command. And now I'll add the package syncfusion.blazor using this .NET add package command hyphen v followed by the version number and hit the enter button. So this will install the latest version of Syncfusion Blazor package. And that's it. I can start to configure the project now in the same way how I did before while using Visual Studio 2019. So I'll open my project, and in the imports.razor file, I'll add the namespace for calendar, which is syncfusion.blazor.calendars. And then within the program.cs file, I'll add the syncfusion.blazor namespace. And then within this async main method, I'll register the Syncfusion Blazor service. I will also register the license key here using my trial key. And then within the index.html file, I'll add the required CSS to render the Syncfusion Blazor components. And finally, within the index component, I'll add the calendar tag with its initial t-value property set to datetime, and that's it. Now I can run my project using the command .NET watch run and hit the enter button. And here you can see a calendar component rendered in the home page. And that's really all you need to know while working with the Syncfusion Blazor components in a client-side WebAssembly app. As this Blazor WebAssembly is still in a preview state, so we keep on making parallel progress together with every Microsoft updates. And we hope we can mark our Blazor components for WebAssembly as final and production ready by May 2020 as per the current launching plan given by Microsoft. Now let me summarize what we have seen so far. First, we have seen how the Blazor WebAssembly app works and how to create a WebAssembly app using Visual Studio 2019. Then we saw how to configure and add Syncfusion Blazor components like calendar and grid to the index component of the application. And finally, we saw how to create the same Blazor WebAssembly app using Visual Studio Code. To see the working of this example, you can download it from the GitHub link, which I have shared in the below description part. You can also grab your chance of getting free licenses for our complete Blazor products if you seems to fit into our community license guidelines. So check if you are eligible for it from the link I have shared in the below description part. Thank you for watching this, and if you find this video as useful, hit the like button and subscribe to our channel to get notified of our new upcoming videos. Thank you.